Good morning, guys. Let's go, Wolf. Let's go, baby. All right, so I have to change the oil again. He doesn't like it, and I have to clean the engine a little bit inside. So that's okay. Yeah, let me put some gloves before I burn my hands on this muffler. Let me see if I can take out the plug, but I can't now. It's very hot. I don't know where to put my hands really when it's hot. Got it. Now somehow I have to hold the hose here. Okay. All right. Okay. All right. Got it. Okay. All right. Let it drain. Stiff. This is a new filter, but you know, unfortunately, I'm gonna get rid of it. Put a new oil. I got the V-twin, so let it drain. It's warm. You see that? Coming down. All right, let it drain a little bit, then take the filter out. And that's how you do it. Okay. So, yeah, I put him there because, no, Xabla, Tora, Xabla means lay down. Because he goes crazy with hair. Look at that, a troublemaker. Look, That's her. That's Harley. Okay. Yes, she's a troublemaker. So we're gonna be putting a V-twin. Okay, I got a new filter. That's a HeFlow. HF170C. Yes, they're good. You know, when I press, you hear the noise before, when I was have the engine running. Look at her. She's looking for troubles. Yes. And they play together, they are friends. And when I press the lever on the clutch, she was making a squeezing noise from the primary, okay? And I think it's the oil. We'll see. All right. Okay, so all right, let me clean a little bit. Oops. All right. Yeah, just a little bit dirt here. It's not really that much. And okay. And let me put some clean oil on the top of this. Look at this oil. Okay. Always do that. Soil. Okay, let me clean my hands. All right. Okay. Just hand tight, okay, but I give it a little crunk on the end, so don't get it too loose. Or if you're not sure, just use a torque wrench, but I've been doing it for years, so I'm not worried about it. All right, let's go to the other side. All right, let's put the plug first, check for any particles of metal. Yeah, I can touch the muffler now. All right, let's put the plug in all the way. Okay. Can you see it? All the way. And clean a little bit here. Let me clean the oil here too, because it's gonna collect dirt easily if you don't clean it, okay? All right, let's put the clamp on. All right. What is the drill? Ah. And I recommend you use something like this, because tightening the clamp, it would otherwise by hand, it would just take time. Okay. All right. I put it on Torgers 8. I think this is good enough. Right there. And put it back in position. Right there. Tied the other clamp onto the frame of the bike. Take a look. Okay, right here. Make sure you squeeze this clamp back right here, so that thing doesn't, like, you know, shake everywhere. All right, and you lose the plug. All right, let's see what else. Do an inspection, put some oil there. Okay, so let's put 2/4 in. You know, this is what's going on here. Come on, Ella. My baby. All right, Ella. Come on. Let's see. All right. Look at that. This is amazing. Yes. This is all daddy. Look at that. Look at that. What are you doing? What are you doing to daddy? What are you doing to daddy? Yes, where's my kiss? Where's my kiss? Where's my kiss? Yes, she's clean. She got all the medicine and everything. So she loves to be sitting up there. What I'm gonna do? Let you have it. All right, so let's put the second quarter, and then I'm gonna start the bike to warm it up a little bit on a regular temperature for, like, you know, 5 minutes something. So this is 2050 V-twin motorcycle oil, and it's supposed to be really good. It's about here, it's about 17 bucks a quarter. Some people are selling it for 20. So it's not a cheap oil. Okay. The thing is, I hope she's gonna like it. Yes, I'm talking about. Okay, put the rest of the oil.
I don't want to fill it up all the way up because the oil tank needs some breathing space.
So I kind of find out the problem. It's not really the oil. I mean the oil of the engine, but that was the oil on the primary. Very low and very dark. I don't know why the bike was not really moving, but it's been there for a while. So I checked the plug also, and it was like just a few metal particles here. That's normal, not too much really. I clean it up. Oil was like down here, okay, like about almost 3/4 of an inch below the disc, and the oil should be right on below on the same level where this disc ends. I'm gonna show you in the manual, but I gotta go get oil now. All right. Okay, so I went and I got some oil, and all right, so it has to go right here. Oil has to go right here on the bottom of that. All right, of the primary of the clutch disc. All right, right here. That's the lever. All right, so it says 30 to 36 ounces. 36 ounces is 1,020 grams. So I'm gonna put two of this at 500 milligrams. All right, and I'm gonna check the level on the bike. So let's see. Okay, so I'm gonna use AMSOIL synthetic V-twin primary. All right. It has ounces here, it's 30 ounces, I think. 30 odds. All right, so let's go with this now. I have cleaned this. All right. Almost 500. And let's go slowly. Yes, I have put the plug in. Oh no, I have not. Ah, shit. Ah, man. Ah, oh, I lost a little bit. It's okay. Ah. All right, last. Just a little bit, thank God. Okay, I don't know what the torque is. I will check this later. It should take the whole quarter. Yes, you have to put the plug. Let's clean that up a little bit. Start over again. Right. Okay. All All right, let's see what's going on. All right, that's almost 500. I'm gonna put 350 and I will check. All right. It says 30 to 36, so 30 is 850. So I'm going to put around 800 now at 30 and we'll see. Okay.
Let me clean this a little bit.
Okay. All right. Let's see. Yeah, it's right there. Okay, it's exactly right there. Okay, you see it? It's right, like touching the disc right there. The white part, the white circle, right there. So which will be good. I'm not gonna tension the clutch yet. I'm not gonna adjust the clutch. From this is how you adjust the clutch from here. Okay, this Allen bolt and the big nut here, all right? Before I do a test. All right, so. You know, when you get a point like that, after 7 months, you know, it's really easy to do mistakes. And as long as the mistakes they're not big, they're not as serious. All right. Okay. So I'm gonna give it another try, and I'm gonna adjust the clutch. All right, I'm gonna show you the book, and I'm gonna show you right now how you do it. I mean, with a book and with a guy I found on YouTube. All right, you lose this knot right here, okay, and you turn this, the bottom one, all the way up till your clutch. It's completely loose, you see that? Okay. The other thing is, I'm gonna tell you is, because I've been through all the whole thing right now, it's you let the bike completely cool down, okay? This is the temperature right now on the bike. So it's still a little bit hot, okay? It's 29 Celsius, all right? Right there. Okay, let's see the cylinders. 28 on the cylinders, okay? It's about what, 75, 78 Fahrenheit, something like that, all right? Now, The other thing you do is, I'm going to do it right now with you, and then I'm going to show you the book. You take the Allen key, okay, and I would recommend a longer Allen key, all right? This is a specific Allen key. I only have two of them, all right? And that's, I can't remember the number of that, but I'm going to show you the other guy video that you know, gives you the numbers and everything on that. But you lose this ball completely by holding, okay, by holding the Allen screw right here, okay, and you go like that. And I can tell you it's not easy if the bike is hot. It's almost impossible, all right? And then you go like that and you break the nut, all right? And this is an 1116, and you need this kind of tool to do that. All right, if you don't have it, go get it if you want to do something like that. All right, then when the nut is nice and loose like that with your finger, all right, take it out of the way and use an Allen key like that, a little bit longer, maybe double the size, and okay. And let it drop, see what it stops, like that. You see it? Like that. All right, let's do it a little bit different way. Yes, this is the clutch adjustment, believe it or not. Okay, so let's see, it drops right here. Maybe I take it out of the way here. All right, don't pressure it. Let it be with the weight, with the force. That's it, right there. You see, it keeps stops on the same place. All right, you see that? Give it a little force. It stops on the same place. All right. Now, Harley Davidson tells you go back half turn. So bring it over here, up to one turn. All right. And this guy on the other video explains this very good. It depends if you live in a hot country. I don't know, in Florida or somewhere, you go more than half turn, all right, if you have high temperatures in your country. And, you know, I don't know if that makes sense, but that's how he explains that. And so what I'm going to do is, you see, it keeps folding on the same spot. You see that? Right there. Right? What I'm going to do is, I'm going to go half turn right here and give it a little more, like let's say 1 hour on the clock, because we have a little bit high temperatures in Greece. So then you just hand tight the nut, holding the Allen key nice and firm, all right? And then very careful. You hold it again and you tie it to 10 new meters. 10 new meters is almost nothing, it's just a little bit. Right there. That's it. All right. And let's look at the book. What it says. You see, we're right here on page 66. All right, the clutch adjustment. Adjustment, proper adjustment. Stand vehicle upright and level, remove clutch cover. See figure 6-9, 6-8, 6-9. Bring this up, then I just told you before, to lose completely the clutch levers. All right, upwards and screw 4, bring it all the way up, all right, to lose control. See figure 6-8. Right here, and loose clutch adjust screw jump nut 2, right here, okay, and turn push rod adjust screw 3 onward, clockwise to take up all free play in push rods. All right, then back out adjusting screw counterwise half to one full turn and tighten jump nut 6 to 10 foot-libbers torque while holding adjusting screw with an Allen wrench. You see what this is what I just did, all right? Okay, squeeze clutch level to maximum limit 3 times. All right, let's see this part now.
You want to back the adjuster off while paying attention to the lever free play. You want to have anywhere from a 16th to an 8th inch of free play. So after you adjust it, you want to run the lever a few times and then check the free play. You'll do this by pulling the cable away from the housing. That's where you measure the free play. You can see we've got about an 1/8 inch here, so we're good to go. Now.
Okay. And also this guy, he's like doing about the same. That's Deploy Garage on May 24, 2017 video.
It stops.
Okay, and you should watch both of these videos, including mine, to get this properly done. All right, and that's a Rocky Mountain ATV MC. All right, so let's do that now. But I will compress. I will follow the book and will compress the lever a little bit here. You see, it's very loose. All right, so let's bring it up a little bit. Okay. So if I can put the GoPro right here, right there, a little bit light. Okay, so now we'll have to do it the other way. All right, let's see. All right, let's see this one. We're almost there. Okay, I'm about there. I'm gonna bring the nut down. And I'm not gonna tension yet. I'm gonna close the tilt-by cover. And it's 10 foot pounds. You don't need a torque wrench for that, just don't go crazy. It's really up to you. If you haven't done that before, yes, follow the book. Okay. And you don't have to remove the oil to do that. All right. All right, let's bring it up a little bit. A little more. I think I'm good there. All right, so I put the floorboards, you know, I finish up the bags, I tie the lines, I got a little details here to stabilize the USB, but it's not really a big deal, you know. I put the seat on, I put some rubber in here so it won't scratch the new fender. Yes, the fender has been repainted, not everything, it's like just a clear. Okay, I might put. I'm gonna put the protector here, the Harley. I don't know what else. I put the air filter on. I don't have to go through that. This is ridiculous easy. Just make sure you put that, and when you put the bolts, you put Loctite here. I would recommend red. One drop. But if you want it, just put blue. I put the floorboards here too. I clean them up a little bit. I have to put the cover on the master cylinder. Crayon is here. Say hi. Hello, baby. Yes, yes. The delivery man came and he got really scared because I have the door open, but he's listening. And he's still a puppy, if you can call this a puppy. I put the cover on the front light. Okay, clean it up and everything. Still have to put the covers on the bolts here. Not really big deal. Okay, and you know, I might take it to the shop to replace the discs and the clutch. I'm talking about the clutch disc. I'm not gonna do this myself. I don't care, you know. And I'm probably gonna do that. Yes, but you know, put the mirrors on. I don't know what else. I have to put the license plate on. I'm probably going to do the clutch to replace the discs and probably the bearing and the wire. Have everything new again, okay? After all this work, you know, why not? All right, so thanks for guys watching, but, you know, hopefully we'll see you see us right next time. Except if something else comes up. I don't know. We are on the 7 month of restoration of this beautiful bike. Check it out. Oh yeah, I gotta clean this filter. I forgot this because I don't have the tool. So when I take it to the shop, I'll let them clean the filter here for the toppers. Just a couple of details and that's it. All right.